My name's Anna Lau. We are in the Clinical Microbiology Lab at the National Institutes of Health. We're in the Clinical Center. This is the hospital of the NIH where all the patients come do their research protocols. And then we run the microbiology lab, so looking for infectious diseases, agents, and ways that we can help treat these patients. We see a lot of bacterial diseases, infections. We see a lot of fungal infections. So they're the two main ones that I focus on. I was born in Sydney, grew up in Sydney, went to college in Sydney, studied pre-med. And then in my second and third year, I took a class of microbiology and infectious diseases and just fell in love with it. And then from there, I did 9 months of just intense research in a hospital in Sydney. So you got to see like the work that you were doing and its impact. And then I came over here for my fellowship, and then I've been offered a position to stay.
Okie dokie.
Perfect. You're welcome. So I take consults during the day from the technologists. And so this is where I prepare micro rounds for the infectious diseases staff and clinicians.
The fun microbacteria.
Mm-hmm.
They want to know if it can wait till Thursday because they're behind.
No, it cannot.
Because I haven't done
it. We can do that. Thank you. Top left. I'm impressed that you guys know where it is without marking it. I see. I see. Perfect. All right. Thank you very much. Hey, Melissa. Okay, this looks odd.
So I got four sets of blood culture bottles. Mm-hmm. So they label them all four with
same label.
Yeah, with different sizes.
Oh, I think I know about this culture. Thank you very much. Okay. You know, we're in an era now of multi-drug resistant organisms. So these are bacteria, fungi, viruses that the antibiotics that we have now in the world aren't big enough to combat them. One of the ones that happened here in the clinical center in 2011 was a bacterial outbreak called Klebsiella Pneumoniae. So this particular bug carried this enzyme called KPC that basically ate up all the antibiotics that the patients were being given. So no matter what you do to treat these patients, there are no antibiotics that are effective. We're looking into rapid detection for these bad types of bacteria and early detection of potential outbreak. This is for the mold database that I built. So we're just gonna take a little bit of this, put it into this tube that contains like beads and ethanol, and then we're just gonna extract the proteins out of it. So we're just gonna pick up a little bit of the mold. And we wanna take it from the edge because that's like the youngest part, and that's where we're gonna find the most abundant proteins. Just kind of pick it off and stick it into the tube and then just mush it up. All right, let's find a plate. So that yellow stuff that I just dropped off were the old proteins from the run before. So we have a clean plate. We extracted it, which takes about 20 minutes or so. So here it is, that's the extracted protein in there, and then there's the squished up mold that's in there. But in the solution, that's where all the proteins are. And so what we're gonna do is just take 1 microliter, it's just like that much in volume, it's hardly anything. And then I'm gonna spot it directly onto this plate. In here, going up this tube, is the big vacuum. So it's a really, really powerful vacuum that the proteins are just gonna fly through to give you your fingerprint. And on the top, there's a detector. And then there's a massive, powerful laser that will hit the proteins that are spotted onto that plate and then make them fly through the vacuum. We're gonna put our new one in and then close that up and stick it back in. I'm gonna set up a program. Here is our target plate that we just put in. So if I scroll over this, you can see that the camera is gonna pass over 2, 3. And this is our protein that we just spotted on with the yellow crystals on top. That's we know awesome. That they're like lookalike molds, so they masquerade around. Yeah. Like, so you can see the laser's hitting the protein and it's giving us this spectrum that's being collected. The light blue line on top, that's the sum of all the fingerprints it's collecting. And then the little one on the bottom that's moving, that's the current hit. Every time it hits, it's gathering 50 good spectra, and it's going to add itself up to 1,000 good fingerprints, and then it'll move on to the next spot. We run it against the entire database, so, and the mold one is the one that I developed. And then we're going to highlight these guys and hit play, and hopefully it'll give us a good ID. So here's our results, and it's listing you the top 10. Green means it scored greater than 2, 3 is the maximum. And then following that, we have these guys that are scoring in the yellow range, and they're pretty good, but they're not as good as greater than 2. And then anything that's red means it was a poor identification. And all the green peaks here showing you where there's an exact match in the database. And so that's how we do identification now, literally within a few minutes. You know, in the clinical micro world, especially where we are at NIH, we have a lot of close interactions with not just the micro people. We have the infectious diseases staff that come down here to tell us about the patients. We have hospital epidemiology who's worried about potential outbreaks. And so whenever there's a bad bug, they're down here asking more questions. Is it related to this bug that we saw last week? And so that's what gets me pumped up, to see that you're really impacting the way that not just a section works or how a person works, but it's how a hospital works, and it's really impacting patient care, which are, you know, the reason why we do this stuff. Get out there, see what's out there, get hands-on experience if you can, talk to as many people as you can. The field is never ending. Like, it's always, always evolving. We're developing new technologies to combat these diseases, but I think there are always room to grow.